In this course, we're going to be studying the material makeup of essentials, and we're going to be referring to what is known as a data sheet. You've probably already have taken a look at some of these in your Now Smell This activities. You'll notice that they're laden with information. So let's take a look now at some of these components that you're going to be seeing in this particular lesson, as well as in your data sheets. This information will be very useful throughout this course, as well as when you want to refer back to it from time to time and look at how to create blends, which oils are the best ones to choose. So let's just look at this now. Each essential oil data sheet is going to contain the following information. You will see the common name. Now, this is the name that the plants refer to, such as rosemary or lavender. The Latin name is going to be the botanical name. That's going to be specific to its species and where we know that each plant has a unique name, so there won't be any confusion about which lavender you're referring to. The botanical family is another component you'll find here. Now, this means that this particular group of species of plants all belongs to the same group. These have been cataloged by botanists and they track each plant. And so this is where we find maybe some of the physical characteristics of the plant are very similar, such as having five leaves or five petals, or we may find that they're in a broader category just known as the plant family. The country of origins is also good to know. Here is where you're going to find out where this particular plant was grown or where it originated, where it was grown initially. And so in some cases, you'll see more than one country listed. And that's, of course, changing over time because more plants are being moved into new areas. The extraction method tells us how this oil was obtained, whether it was steam distilled, maybe it was used through a solvent. And so this helps us to understand the chemistry makeup of the plant as well as how the oil may be used. There are certain oils that you would not want to ingest as well, and you want to know that based on its way it was distilled. Now for aroma, this is great for knowing when you are blending or you're trying to create maybe a cologne or body splash. And so knowing its aroma and its characteristics, things that are unique to this particular scent, is helpful to know. And that, of course, may be up to you as well as your personal preference of whether you consider it to be fresh or minty. But this does help those who are using them for blending to know and have just a good idea of maybe this is a citrus or this is something that would be considered more herbal. Now, when we look at the note, professional perfumers or noses are very aware of each note. This is determined by the velocity of the oil or its evaporation rate. And so this is going to be based on how fast it evaporates. Now you'll note in your level one textbook, we have a breakdown of what this entails and more detail about that. The chemistry families. Now this is really where it gets very interesting, and we cover the chemistry more in level two. Essential oils contain thousands of chemical components, and so the chemists have placed them into families or groups based on their chemical makeup. And so each chemical family is going to share some therapeutic properties, so that way we can sort of identify whether this is going to be an antispasmatic or antibacterial oil or antiviral oil and so on. It also helps us to know it's for safety purposes, whether this is a good oil to use for a particular blend. And then looking at page 56 in our level one book, we look at the precautions. Any safety concerns or things that we should be aware of, we want to make sure that we take these into consideration when we're blending or putting something together for a client. Safety data is also listed because we want to know any safety concerns, any cautions regarding this particular usage of the oil. Okay, so if we know that we should not be putting it in bath water, or if it's something that should not be maybe inhaled directly from an inhaler, those are the things we want to be aware of. Lastly, we want to look at its therapeutic properties. Now, in blending, this is really good information that we want to have so that we can understand an essential oil's therapeutic properties that will be beneficial for that blend. Now, in your workbook, you'll find there is a section for the essential oil data sheet form. These are blank forms. Now, you will want to take some of the oils that you have in your own collection that you don't have a data sheet on and create this for your oils. So you'll be adding your essential oil name, you'll write a brief description about that oil, and you'll fill in this information such as the country of origin, the extraction method, the plant parts used, and so on. This is information that you may have to go back on the website that you purchased the oil from, or you may need to just do a little bit of research and start gathering this information to fill in this part. You'll also want to make note of the precautions, the therapeutic properties that you're aware of, and the uses. This is going to be very good to have on hand when you're making your own blends, as well as just having this as a great reference tool for later